Fadi, welcome to us.
Thank you for having me.
Este plăcerea noastră să te avem invitat în Roman, studioul de televiziune CNS Roman.
It's our pleasure that you are here on this TV CNS Roman.
Thank you.
De mult timp plănuiam acest interviu să-l avem aici în Roman și iată te alături de noi.
We planned this for a long time and we're happy that you're here.
I'm happy today. I'm happy I'm here too. Thank you so much, Mark, because I know you had a big part of this, so I appreciate it. Thank you, Roman, for having me. So I'm excited to perform.
Mulțumesc, Mark, că ai avut și tu o mare parte din ai contribuit și tu la seara aceasta și de-abia aștept să ne distrăm în seara asta.
Știm că ești în plin turneu de promovare al noului tău single Crazy. Okay.
We know you have your promotor right now Crazy for
yeah,
Crazy.
Yeah. That's right. Yeah.
Cum au decurs filmările la acest clip?
How was the shooting for the video?
It was a lot of fun. It was fun because I had my team in Australia. They've worked on a lot of my past videos and we came together to do something different and something creative and something cool and something classic. And I'm just happy that, you know, Romania has loved the song so much and, you know, people really appreciate it. And it was fun. It was a fun video to do. Yeah.
This is great.
Yeah.
Povestește-ne puțin despre cum ai început să cânți, începuturile tale.
Tell us about your musical story, your career, how you started.
So when I was 13 years old, I started writing and recording over popular tracks. I used to write my own lyrics and melodies and put them over top 40 instrumentals because I didn't have a producer when I first started, you understand? So I uploaded them on a website called SoundClick, which is like SoundCloud. Yeah. And then I got discovered by Ronnie Diamond, who's my manager in Australia. Yeah. He's in Australia, but he's also my manager around the world. He discovered me through, he was looking for an artist and he saw my name, Fadi, and he was like, ah, oh, that's a cool name. He's like, that sounds Arabic. Let me check this guy out.
Yes.
So then, yeah, so then he checked it out. He liked what he heard. And then I started producing my own music. So I learned how to produce music. So I started producing, writing, recording, mixing, everything. And then I just worked really, really hard and performed in different clubs and you know, started off really small and then slowly built my fan base and, you know, and built my following and built a catalog of music.
Okay.
And it was tough. It was really, really tough starting out. I was working two jobs while doing music for many years. And then thank God the success came, you know, after
a few years.
Thank you.
You know,
thank you. And yeah, you know, I'm here today because of hard work and determination and because I love what I do, so
yes, for sure. Translate, please.
We'll translate all of that.
Am început de foarte tânăr, făceam remixuri tot felul de piese pe un site de muzică până am fost descoperit de Ronnie, care este managerul actual. Am muncit din greu, aveam două slujbe, până am ajuns ce sunt acum, am început de jos, să zicem așa. Am cântat în multe cluburi, în multe părți ale lumii, până am început să fiu cine sunt astăzi și am muncit foarte mult.
Ok. La noi în România ai fost pe primul loc timp de 6 săptămâni cu piesa Love Till You Cry. Ce ne poți spune despre momentul când ai aflat că în România ești pe primul loc?
Yeah, when you first topped Romania 6 weeks with Love Till You Cry, what did you feel?
When what? What happened? When the success?
When the success
happened in Romania?
Was number one for 6 weeks.
I couldn't believe it. It was like I was in Germany at this point. I had my first international show in Germany for free.
Okay.
and me and my manager Ronnie were waiting for
so
a train.
Chatted in Europe, being from other continent.
Exactly. Well, I didn't expect it. I didn't know much about Romania, first of all, so I didn't know what to expect. And Love Till You Cry was supposed to be just a track that I did for fun. You know, it wasn't a single for Australia. We had another song that was for radio for Australia, and Laugh Till You Cry was like the B-side.
Yeah.
And then the B-side became the bigger success.
Yeah.
And then it was amazing. And like I said, we were in Germany. I was looking at the video status, and I noticed the video was going up like 100,000 a day, and I was like, what's going on? Like, something's happening somewhere, I don't know what's happening. And then Adriano, my tour manager, he hit me up, didn't hit me up, hit my management up, and was like, we want to bring Fady to Romania for a tour. And then it all kind of happened from there.
Yes.
Deci eram în Europa, în Germania, unde aveam un concert gratis și nu veneam să cred că într-o țară ca România se întâmplase lucrul acesta și piesa mea era number one timp de 6 săptămâni, nu știam nimic despre această țară și mă gândeam ce se întâmplă, până când Adriano, managerul de acum de turneu, aranja să-l aducă în România în sfârșit. Da.
Yes. De atunci ai venit foarte des în România. Ce te atrage să vii foarte des aici?
From then you came so often to Romania. What attracted you the most to be here, to come back?
It was just honestly, it's been the love in Romania. I've also formed a lot of good friendships in Romania, good people. And I don't know. I think I always have a soft spot for Romania because it all started. It didn't all start in Romania, but you know, it was such a big impact from Romania. So I always feel like I owe it to Romania to continue to come back, and plus it's fun, I enjoy it.
Yes. Mai tot timpul ești în turnee, urmărim oriunde ai concerte. Tu ai timp de viață personală?
You're always on tour, you have time for your personal life and stuff like that.
Sometimes it gets very hard for my personal life because I'm always on tour and I'm always traveling and working. But I like to make time as much as I can, you know? And when I make time, I switch everything off. So, and focus on my personal life.
Când a fost ultima dată când ți-ai văzut familia din Australia?
When was the last time when you saw your family from Australia?
It was about maybe 6 weeks ago.
Yeah.
6 weeks ago.
Oh,
yeah.
This is great.
Yeah, 6 weeks.
Ai timp liber și cum ți-l petreci?
What do you do in your free time? How do you spend it?
I spend it pretty much, my free time, I don't know, I guess my free time is working on music, even though it's not free. My free time. And then, you know, just like watching trashy TV shows and just relaxing and enjoying life. I like going for, I like exploring wherever, whatever city I'm in. If I've got like a free day, I like to go for a walk and be a tourist. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah, and go to the movies. I love going to the movies.
Yeah?
Yeah, even if it's by myself.
Te-ai gândit vreodată să te stabilești în România? Pentru că petreci mult timp.
You ever thought to move in Romania for good, like, because you're always here?
Yeah, of course. I always think about moving to Romania for good, but my family's in Australia, my home's in Australia, so, you know.
Would be hard.
It's a little bit, my base is always going to be in Australia, I think, you know. But when I'm on tour, it's nice to sometimes.
Ok, urmează câteva întrebări scurte.
Some short questions.
Ok.
Okay.
Care este prețul plătit de Fady pentru celebritate?
The price of success.
Oh, the price of success?
Yeah. Yes.
The sacrifice?
Yes, everything.
Private life.
Okay.
And always having to be happy when sometimes you're not. And you be judged. You're judged very hard on everything. You know, if things don't go well on stage, it's my fault. It's not anyone else's fault because they think, oh, it's Fady. If a music video isn't good, oh, it's Fady. If a song isn't good, it's Fady. If, you know, I don't look good or if I have a bad day or if whatever it is, it's like, it's, there's no, I can't really have a good explanation or good reason. It's, you know, it's, all the spotlight is on me, which is nice, but when you're having a bad day, you know,
you're
kind
not
of,
in the mood.
Yeah, you gotta take it.
It's not so easy.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's okay. It's a small sacrifice. It's not so big. I love what I do, so you know, if that means that's fine.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Translate.
Care este prețul succesului? Mereu trebuie să fiu happy, să arăt bine, chiar dacă am o zi proastă, trebuie să zâmbesc pentru că asta e și trebuie să faci sacrificii, oricât de mici, ca să demonstrezi lumii că te simți bine și, mă rog.
Ok. Care este artistul preferat din România? Și dacă te-ar plăcea să colaborezi cu cineva?
Favorite artist from Romania.
Ina.
yeah, I mean, Ina is definitely one of my favorites from Romania.
Only?
There's many talented artists in Romania, but Ina would probably be one of my top favorites. Because I like her passion, I like her drive, I like the fact that she... I've met her as well, we had a very nice conversation, and she's very down to earth and nice. So.
But Alexandra Stan?
Alexandra Stan is a nice,
you like,
nice, nice, she's very nice as well, yeah, she's very talented, yeah.
Okay, great,
yeah.
Ce artist îți place din România? Am cunoscut-o pe Ina de curând, este foarte cu picioarele pe pământ, este o artistă excepțională și Alexandra Stan, sunt foarte mulți artiști români. Nu-i cunoaște chiar pe toți, dar în mare parte cei care sunt internaționali.
Ce te inspiră când creezi muzică?
What inspires you in your songs?
You know, traveling inspires me a lot because I hear different kinds of music all around the world.
Okay.
You know, if I'm in the shopping center and I hear a song and I'm just like, oh, I shazam it straight away. And I'm just like, okay, this is cool. Gives me some ideas. When it comes to content with my lyrics, it comes down to how I'm feeling on the day, my life, maybe experience that my friend is having. So I'm just like, oh, that's, you know, let me write something about this, this person. Or sometimes my fans inspire me as well to do something different and creative. So yeah,
this is great.
Mm-hmm. Ce te inspiră în piesele tale? Cel mai mult când călătoresc și aud ceva, o piesă specială și am anumite idei, fanii mei mă inspiră sau ce trăiește un prieten sau viața mea personală sau multe chestii.
Ești tot timpul îmbrăcat bine, la modă, de unde te inspiri?
You're always dressed well.
Mulți
What inspires you?
Pentru că pentru mulți fani tu ești o inspirație.
What inspires me to dress well?
Yes.
How,
yes.
I don't know. I just sometimes I dress well, sometimes I don't. You can ask my dancers. Sometimes they say that, yeah, you know, what I wore was crap.
Your dancers.
Ain't that right, Arish? No. no, like I don't know. I like to dress up. I like to, you know, actually I like to dress up when I'm, you know, about to hit the stage or the red carpet or I'm going out to, but generally if I didn't have the spotlight on me, I think I would probably dress down. Tracksuit, I don't give a damn. I don't care, you know, but
it's okay.
Yeah, but you know, I style myself. So everything that you see,
okay,
from the videos to the photo shoots or whatever, the shows, it's styled by me. So
okay.
Yeah.
Te îmbraci foarte bine, de unde te inspiri? Îmi place să am un stil al meu și tot ce vedeți sunt ideile mele.
Hmm. Ok.
That was a short translation.
Yeah.
Cum te vezi peste 10 ani?
How do you see yourself in 10 years?
I see myself in 10 years. I don't know,
Singing, hopefully.
Yeah, I mean, I'll you know, I don't think I can ever stop doing music. I'll be a part of it somehow. You know, kind of just maybe being a better version of me, more calm, less stressed. You know what I mean? You know, building a beautiful family and continuing on enjoying
great
my
plans.
Life. Yeah.
Great.
Cum te vezi peste 10 ani? Sper să fac tot muzică. Să am o familie, să mă reinventez, poate să fiu o altă versiune a mea.
Ai foarte mulți fani în România și știu că o parte din ei te însoțesc aproximativ permanent în concerte. Cum vezi tu acest lucru?
That's the best part. You have so many fans in Romania, some of them come everywhere.
Yeah.
How do you feel about it?
Yeah, it's incredible. It's the best thing and I love it so much and I appreciate it so much because, you know, they don't have to do it and I always try and give the best show possible. No matter where I go, you know, and I can't do it without them. So I remember these the fans that come to all of my shows. I remember their names. I know about them. I connect with them in a personal level because they become more than just fans. Like they don't become like more than fans to me. They become my friends, like my family. So
they love you so much, you know.
Thank you. Yeah.
Okay.
I love them too. And,
primești foarte multe cadouri. Spune-ne și nouă un cadou mai ciudat pe care l-ai primit.
You receive so many gifts. Tell us a weird gift or something. if there was any weird gift.
A weird gift. I feel like I got something. I think like a lipstick.
Yes.
Yeah. There was like a you know that one that you like. You pull it out and it's a brush and you...
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I don't know if it was lip gloss or lipstick or something.
Oh my God, for me?
Maybe she forgot it there.
I was like, wow, this is perfect. Yeah, that was random. So, yeah, yeah. Okay. But I've received really cool gifts, you know, very, very cool gifts. And, yeah.
Un cadou ciudat pe care l-ai primit, poate un ruj. Dar cel mai multe cadouri sunt interesante și frumoase și...
Și tot la acest capitol, dacă ai primit declarații de dragoste de la fane...
if some fans proposed you or they told you they love you so much and I don't know.
Just I love you so much or more?
More than that.
Oh yeah, I mean, it happens.
Or proposed you, I don't know.
Yeah, it happens, it happens, it happens and, you know, I see my fans as something, you know, very close to my heart, and I don't like to hurt them, you know, and I like to be honest with them and know that I, you know, love them as my family, as my friend, and you know, it's definitely come to me. I've had some strange proposals too, very strange proposals, you know. Someone asked me how my sex life was because I travel so much, you know. They said, you know, what how do you, you know, if I can, if I can help, I can help. And I'm just like, it's, yeah, so, anyway.
Dacă ai avut vreo propunere, să zicem, nu știu, cerere în căsătorie sau declarații de dragoste de la fani sau ceva ciudat, da, să zicem că da, adică, nu știu, majoritatea fanilor mei sunt drăguți și vreau să știu că iubesc foarte mult și sunt aproape de inima mea și consider familia și prietenii mei de suflet și nu vreau să-i rănesc și încerc să fiu sincer cu ei.
Se apropie o vară fierbinte și știm că ai concerte în toată lumea. Ne poți spune câteva localități sau...
It's gonna be a hot summer and you're gonna be touring.
Unde pot găsi fanii?
Can you tell us where or, I don't know, the next show?
Well, right now, I just got off a big tour, from Bahrain to Germany, to, I don't remember where else I went, man, I can't...
I don't know, Turkey.
Oh, Turkey.
Turkey,
yeah,
Turkey, Romania.
Yeah, and, you know, if you want to check out any upcoming shows, you just head to faded.com.
Okay.
You know, yeah, I'm always keeping busy, so, yeah, yeah.
On my page.
Tradu,
se apropie vara fierbinte. Ce ne poți spune despre următoarele concerte? Am avut un turneu larg din Germania până în Turcia, România, iarăși România. Cine dorește să afle informații despre show-urile mele, să intre pe fidi.com sau să mă urmărească pe Instagram, Facebook, oriunde altundeva, unde am pagini. Sau
yeah, Facebook, Instagram,
sau,
all
da.
That. Yep, yep, that's right.
Okay, Fadi, noi îți mulțumim pentru că ai fost alături de noi, îți mulțumim că ai onorat invitația și în seara asta vom urmări cu interes show-ul pe care îl vei avea în orașul roman.
We thank you so much for tonight and for this interview and we're gonna party with you.
Yeah, let's enjoy the show.
Tonight, and so
thank you so much. Mulțumim, o mulțumesc. Thank you so much. And thank you for all the love and support. Thank you.
Stimați telespectatori, mulțumim. La revedere!